Welcome back to Afternoon Live. Football games, school dances, drama productions, high school is packed with activities for many kids. But what if your child is socially anxious and sees these events as frightening instead of fun? We'll get advice now with parents and teen life coach Barb Steinberg is with us today. Hi, Barb.
Hi, how are you?
Good. Okay, so we're talking social anxiety. I'm curious, what's the difference or what are the signs of a socially anxious child versus a shy child?
Great question. So, you know, being shy and a little bit nervous is certainly, or self-conscious, is certainly a part of growing up and being a teenager. The difference is a socially anxious child, their fear is out of proportion for the social event or situation that they're in. It's persistent, it's debilitating, and it affects almost every area of their lives.
So what are the signs of your child being socially anxious?
Yeah, so I'll tell you some behavioral signs and some physical signs. So behaviorally, you might see a child who appears scared and worried and anxious to talk or speak up or be around in a social setting. They are not talking even when they want to. They're unable to ask questions in class or raise their hand. They can't advocate or ask for help. They have trouble ordering food or maybe talking to an adult like a doctor. They have a hard time saying yes when they're invited to social events or inviting other people. They're thinking for days and weeks about what they're going to say before they go to this public event. They're criticizing themselves after they've interacted with someone.
So do you kind of encourage and almost make your child go to these events and these commitments, or do you let them withdraw?
Yeah, another great question. So I think one of the great things, there's so many things that we can do as parents. But one of the things that we need to always consider is one of their ways of coping with this social anxiety is to avoid the social situations that cause the anxiety. It's uncomfortable. The more that we allow that, the more the fear grows and that social anxiety grows. So when they're wanting us to order their food at the restaurant, we don't want to do that. When they want us to speak up and the doctor's asking them a question, we don't want to do that because we're just enabling that fear to grow.
I sometimes think when we enable our children about anything, it's because sometimes we look at ourselves and say, well, it's because I would have done that, or I am that way actually too. So it could be very socially anxious parents, right? Who are also, they're trying to get into that mix and be at the school events, and it's hard for them as well. So what do you say to the parents who feel that same way?
The parents that are also feeling socially anxious?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so, you know, that actually could be a really great way for you and your child together to educate yourselves on what are the negative beliefs and the catastrophic thinking that we have that causes the fear of us speaking up or interacting socially, and then challenging those beliefs. Will that thing that I'm really afraid of, like my peers laughing at me, will that really happen? Has that ever happened? If it did happen, would I be okay 5 or 10 years from now? Could something good happen if I actually speak up in this scenario? We also talk about rating your level of anxiety prior to the social event or interaction and rating it after. For example, I have a girl that I'm coaching right now, terrified to go to the school dance on Friday with her friends. She went, super brave. Her anxiety level was a 7 prior to that dance. I asked, what was it afterwards? It was a 0. She had such a great time. You could literally see her self-esteem, her feelings of being capable, her social growth, all came from that one event. So it's practicing over time. And if parents have it, they can practice too with their kids and talk about it.
What did you tell her? Did you tell her to say something to herself before she walked in that door? What was your advice?
Yeah, so there are many tools that we use in coaching, but one is we talk about what are your anxious thoughts. So what are the negative beliefs that you have? What are the fears, right? Will they happen? Will you be okay if they do happen? How will you handle them if they do happen? Then we talk about coping thoughts. So what are thoughts that you can think to counteract the fear that you have? And then we also teach, you know, relaxation techniques. So deep breathing in those moments that you're really scared, and having a plan of how you will handle it. What will you say? What will you ask your friend to do to support you during this moment in the dance?
What are the biggest mistakes that people make?
I mean, honestly, the biggest one is allowing the avoidance. So kids will say, nobody likes me, I'm a loser, I don't like school, I don't want to go to school, I have a headache, I have a stomach ache, I'm dizzy, I'm sick, to avoid it. And as parents, we don't like to see our kids struggle. It hurts us too. So we want to really gently, lovingly educate and support while encouraging them to go ahead and try this thing. For example, I have so many girls that are afraid of ordering food or going to the door and getting the food from the delivery person and having to interact with them. So another thing that we do is an anxiety scale, 0 to 10, and rating different interactions and the level of anxiety that you feel. And so we will start small, exposing small. So maybe it's a 1 on the scale is smiling at someone in the hallway, and a 10 is raising my hand and asking a question in class. So slowly working your way up that scale and exposing yourself to challenge those negative beliefs.
Such great advice. Thank you so much, Barb. Good to see you.
You too.
You guys are going to have more information about Barb on our website at katu.com, but stick right there.